In many of the prototyping and resin casting videos that I make, inevitably somebody leaves the comment, "Dude, you're wasting your time. Just scan it and 3D print it." Well, that's an incredibly ignorant comment to sort of make. And in this video, I'm going to take this object, we're going to scan it, Klaus Kühnen is going to rebuild the surfaces, and then we're going to print it. And at the very end, I'm going to reveal one of the really big reasons that everybody overlooks on why scanning and 3D printing the object is really not the way to go for most of the pre-production prototyping work that I do.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred Backpack Hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys. It's an incredibly versatile tool. You can use it anywhere in your home or office. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel. I want to welcome new sponsor to the channel, JLC PCB. They offer 3D printing services right to your door. They offer SLA, MJF, SLM, FDM, and SLS printing, resin, nylon, ABS, and stainless steel. Upload your files for an instant quote. Link in the description below. Go check them out for your next project. I'm going to use my 3D Maker Pro mole to scan this object for this video. It's great for small objects. If you want to scan bigger stuff, you're going to go with the links, and I'll leave links in the description below. Here's the data that we get, and this is what we're going to give to Klaus to make nice surface data with.
This, who are you?
I'm Klaus Kühnen.
Oh, very cool. Very cool. Klaus, what do you do?
I teach interior design, industrial design at Wayne State.
Okay. You do anything else beside that? Are you good at CAD?
Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
Yeah.
Klaus has a YouTube channel all about CAD, pretty much. Would you say you have any videos about anything else? No.
I think I'm the Bob Ross.
You're the Bob Ross.
Yeah, so 3D modeling.
Bob Ross 3D modeling here. So Klaus is going to show us workflow of a scanned model to create some data, because everybody says, oh, just scan it. Why make a resin printed part if you could just scan it and print it? And that is easier said than done. Mm-hmm. If you want to have good surfaces, you really need to rebuild your scan with some good CAD data.
Yep.
And that's what you're going to sort of show your workflow and how you do that.
And it's also pretty easy to do today.
Okay, yeah, good.
Yeah.
Good. It's not easy enough for me to do.
Ah, you will say it's easy.
Okay. All right.
Very logical.
Okay. So what we're looking at here on the screen, though, is the scan data of this little vehicle shape, which, by the way, I need to say I had nothing to do with the design of this shape. It's not the most beautiful thing. So this is the scan.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're in Blender, and you've pulled in the OBJ scan, and now you're going to recreate this CAD. So what do you do first?
Well, one of the first things to do is actually just the roof geometry. Let me turn everything off so you can see how simple this geometry is.
So you create an outline based on the form.
Correct. Now, from the top, make it round. I try to follow that all the edges. And now I have basically this top surface. Also here, and this is actually interesting to show, this is not as good. This is kind of good.
Yeah.
Which is also why later I will split the model into half. I work with the good side and then mirror over the other side. Because I have step two here. So this second step, there you can see already how I started modeling out parts of the side of the car too, if I remove this. Well, essentially, you know, the way how this works is we can select 2 points, then it's an edge, and then I extrude this down, move this over a little bit, extrude this down, move this over. Mm. Let's say I do the same here, and then you can fill in more faces. So if this...
That's how you would have built the other side.
Yeah. Exactly.
Gotcha.
Here, for example, now we have half of the piece. And I still actually have here this shrink wrap command, because it still helps to project actually this onto the car.
Mm-hmm.
But the geometry is already very close. So in some cases, it doesn't have to move very far, like the roof. And in some cases, it will still move a lot. For example, here the fillet. And also in this way, I don't really have to model the fillets as perfectly. I added some extra loop cuts here.
Mm-hmm.
So those here to have more points in that corner so that it will capture actually building that fillet better.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then what happens after that?
Yeah. Well, you make 2 pieces.
You mirror it.
Yeah. Added a mirror modifier. So now you have a whole piece. Yeah, and then comes really the question, okay, how do we bring this over to
into Fusion?
Yeah, no? So there's, however, one tiny problem. This model is very low polygon, 128 points.
Uh-huh.
That's all, no? So what I had to do was to actually bake the mesh.
What does that mean exactly?
So baking means there you can see the amount of rectangles.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided on a good amount that wasn't too heavy, but very close to the car body. And then you apply this modifier and it really recreates a new body with this level of polygon.
Gotcha. Because that looks very nice.
Yeah. And this is basically what you see here.
That's what gets exported.
Yeah.
Gets exported.
Yeah. So this is kind of dense. Yeah. Okay. It is. But you can take this, bring this into any CAD application that can convert a polygon model into a NURB surface, for example, Fusion 360 and T-splines or Rhino, and then you add your thickness to it, and that's it.
We've exported the model out of Blender and into Fusion, and this is what we get.
There we are. So there's just a polygon mesh. First thing what we have to do now is we go to T-splines, and then we have to convert that mesh into T-splines. So there's now the converted T-spline model.
Okay, so that's basically a surface. It has no thickness.
Correct.
And if we want to 3D print this, we need to make it a surface. And I don't want to make it solid. I just want to have it, you know, have a thickness, basically.
Correct. Yeah. And what we can do now is we simply go to thicken and give this... You want 2 millimeters?
2 millimeters, yeah, sure.
To the inside, okay. So -2 millimeters. Now we have a solid body.
A body, yeah, let's see that. Now I can print this. So let's zoom in. And so this is why you need to clean this up.
Yeah, exactly.
From the thickened part.
0.5 of a millimeter.
Okay, not very much. We just want to make it flat on the bottom,
and
basically.
Clean, yeah, and then we go split body. Okay, there we are.
And now if we do a side view.
So this one we would like to remove, not delete. Otherwise your stuff is gone. And there.
Nice and flat now. Okay. Awesome. Okay.
Very good.
Cool. That's awesome. Thank you, Klaus.
Do I deserve the Bob Ross snack?
Yeah, sure. Bob Ross is good.
Yeah.
We'll have to get you a wig.
Now, if you have a 3D printer, you could 3D print the new data that you have. I'm printing one on a resin printer here. This is a Form 2. However, if you don't have a 3D printer, another option would be to go to some place that could print it for you, like JLC PCB.
The part has arrived. Let's unbox it. Lots of bubble wrap. Well wrapped. Nice. This is a good piece. We'll compare that to the master original that we scanned. Same size, same everything. I mean, it really should look the same, particularly after we cleaned up the data. So this is a good reproduction. Here's the SLA 3D printed part. It was a lot of work. You had to scan it, clean up the data, print it, have it sent out to be printed if you don't have the capabilities in-house to do that. And this is a nice part. But if we wanted to finish this, we'd still need to prime it and you would see all the build lines. And that would still be a lot of extra work to get a nice, one nice part. Whereas if I resin cast this part, it comes out of the mold, perfect, finished, ready to be painted or primed, no sanding or finishing needed. This is something that everybody overlooks, right? And if it was an FDM part, it'd be even nastier, right? You'd have a ton more work to do. So when I'm doing pre-production prototype sample parts for my clients or trying to get a super high quality finish, nothing at this day and age beats this cast part right here. These resin 3D printed things, I use them more and more often, but they have their place and they're not quite what I need in certain instances for pre-production, high quality prototype samples.
No, actually, this hair is going actually next week.
Is it?
Yeah, I have to scan my head.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what? So the Bob Ross wig fits better?
No. Funny thing, actually, I modeled my head during graduate school.
Okay.
And I don't want to know how close I got from photos.
Oh, using photogrammetry, then you're going to scan it.
No, they're actually, I just use reference photos. But no, for the scanning, yeah, I will use photogrammetry.
And you're going to shave your head?
Yeah,
for
this? It has to go down to the skin, so otherwise the hair is covering
my skull. And why do you need to do this? Just because you want to?
Yeah. To the demise of my wife.
Yeah.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.